Hi guys, my name's Dustin Blevins. I'm the owner of Simply Spiders. Today I'm gonna show you guys how to rehouse a T. seledonia baby that I produced. These species are one of my favorite species. They're a type of trapdoor spider from Brazil. They have multiple metallic coloring and they stay very, very small. Door species have always been a passion of mine, and I feel that the T. seledonia is one of the most beautiful door species there are in the hobby. With T. seledonia, there are a lot of different variables to their care, so hopefully in this video we can go over most of them. There's also a lot of information out there on the care of T. seledonia, and people take care of them different ways. This is the way I do. Today we're going to rehouse one of the babies that I produced. This is one of my friends, and they have it in a very interesting, questionable enclosure, and it has yet to make a trapdoor. I believe it's molted 3 times since the egg sac. And as we rehouse it, I'll go step by step and show you a little bit of the seledonia, actually a little bit of what materials I use for the trapdoor mixture, and what kind of humidity and temperatures I keep them at. So there are 3 main ingredients to my trapdoor mix. I use, first is sphagnum moss, where you can locate at any PetSmart or local pet store. I also use cut up Simply Spiders reindeer moss that has been dyed with food grade dye. That's why it's so greenish. And then I also grind up cork bark that has a little bit of lichen chunks. That's what this little newspapery flakes are, is just lichen. And I grind 2 pieces of cork bark together and use the little flakes to make the trap mixture. And what I do is take a little bit of this sphagnum moss, a little pinch, put in a little container like so, a little bit of the reindeer, about 1/3 of each, and then just a little bit of the cork bark, maybe a little bit more of that cork bark. There we go. And then you're just gonna take it, throw that paintbrush, and stir it around like such. And then you got a perfectly blended seledonia trap mixture right here. Actually, I think I'm gonna add just a tad bit more cork bark. Alrighty. Once you have this ready to go, we can set this off to the side and we'll cup our seledonia. Alright, so this is what I use to keep and house seledonia until they get about 1.5 inches. They will actually make multiple trapdoors in this enclosure. What I start off with is one of our arboreal kits from Simply Spiders. Has the open vent for feeding and watering, has plenty of cross ventilation. You're gonna have to look for a piece of wood that has many divots. You're looking for things that actually go into a point more so than anything. And then what you're gonna do is fill this up to about 1 inch. This is about 2 inches, maybe a little bit more, 2.25 inches of substrate. And then you're gonna take your trap mix that we made earlier, right here with the sphagnum moss, the cork bark, and a little bit of my reindeer moss. And I'm just gonna gently put some around in here, in the front, and then in the back. And then just pour some right over on top. Okay, now with this trap mix, it is very important that you consistently add more as the seledonia grows. So about every 2 weeks, I add a little bit more trap mix. Now, I also keep the bottom of the enclosure very moist underneath the trap mix. And then I don't actually ever spray any of the trap mix. Once it gets wet, it will clump together over time. So what I do is actually use a syringe, water the bottom of the soil so that is still very moist, and then I take the lid off and I spray the inside around here for the water. I do that once a week, and then I also drop 2 drops across their trap door once they've made it. Now, once they are actually in here, seledonia can take one day to multiple weeks to make trapdoors. It really just depends on them. I feed them as slings, usually 3 small fruit flies or 1/1/8 inch cricket, once every 4 to 7 days. But I'm gonna rehouse it and then I will show you what it looks like when it's inside of its new enclosure. Now she is comfortable and in her new enclosure. So what I'm gonna do is grab this water bottle and, thank you, I'm gonna spray down the inside of this. Nice, where just where there's a little bit of water around, dump out any excess. I'm just gonna slide this over top like so. Go find the locking part. And now we have a freshly made seledonia enclosure. That is a brother or sister of the one we just rehoused trapdoor. This is actually the trapdoor right here. This is a trapdoor in progress for a seledonia sling. Hasn't added any moss or anything yet. Well, folks, that is the basics of T. seledonia housing. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure you post below. Make sure you subscribe and like to our channel. And also, if you have any experience with seledonia and want to share yours, please make sure you comment below as well. It's been a pleasure. This is my first episode. Kind of nervous, so we'll get better with time. Definitely enjoy this, and I hope in the future that I can provide great material for you guys, easy tricks and stuff that we can do to make sure that this hobby and the people in the hobby are taken care of as well. But seledonia is by far one of my favorite species, and over time I feel they'll be more populated in the United States, and I encourage everybody at the chance to get one to do it, because they're an amazing species and there's far and few between smaller trapdoor spiders that I truly enjoy. So you all have a great night. Enjoy yourselves. Take care.